the before I come to CC per se, that shift has to be understood again. The shift is, we are saying that every child has a right not only to be in a class, but a right to learn.
Okay.
Secondly, we have said that children learn by being engaged and creating their own understanding, and our job is to facilitate that. Now, in this scenario, if at the end of 3 months that you find that a student has not learned, then it's too late to go back. You've already lost the time. So it is imperative that you should know whether students are learning or not as you do the teaching process. That's why assessment has to be continuous. It cannot be once in a while. Because if it is once in a while, you cannot go back and correct it. However, if I'm teaching today and I find my students have not learned, the very next day I can make a difference and actually improve things. So that there is growth. We have also said as part of the right to education, as part of our curriculum, that just becoming, say, good in mathematics but being a bad human being is not education. Education is about developing as a whole person. So you have to look at all the dimensions. That's why it has to be comprehensive in nature. So there is, the point I'm making is, it is logical to do assessment which is continuous and comprehensive. It is not, this is not the whim and fancy of some government thing. There is of course a mistake in the idea. The mistake is like this, that by definition, evaluation is something which is done at the end. Alright, so actually it should be continuous comprehensive assessment. And Kerala does call it CCA, I think, for this very reason. And actually it is meant to be CCA, so I can say that. It was a kind of clerical mistake, you can say, and since it was already there in the policy documents, people couldn't go back and change it. But what is intended is continuous comprehensive assessment. So in continuous comprehensive assessment, there are only three things, and they are very easy to do. Whatever else is being done in the name of some formative, summative, more test, unit test, this is all bunk. This is an industry. You know, so much so that now you have, you know, HP is selling its printers, saying that if you have our printer, your child will do better in classroom exam. It's stupid. What is CCA? CCA is like when you cook food, you keep tasting to see whether it's coming out okay or not. That's how it is. The only difference is that all teachers always know whether children are learning or not. The only difference is that you are recording it. So the way to do it is, first question you ask yourself is, have I done what I was supposed to do? So when you make a plan, you write yourself what you're supposed to teach, what activity or process you're going to do. You might also write, if you think there's any student who is less likely to learn or is at risk, what you will do for that child. That's your plan in just few words. And when you review your plan at the end of the day, if you did it as you planned, you put a tick mark. If you didn't do it as you planned or couldn't do it as fully, just put a question mark. If you did exactly as planned, tick. If you didn't do at all, put a cross. That's it. That's the review. You don't need to do much more. The important thing is that when you plan next, you should look at it. If you have a question mark or a cross, you have to repeat something of the previous time. You cannot just move. Just this ordinary act ensures that there is a continuity in teaching. So it doesn't need much time. The second thing is, as you teach, you need to keep a simple record of whether students are learning as per your expectation or not. Now, there are a large number of learning objectives in which the teacher's impression is enough for us. For example, can the students have the students develop confidence? Can they hold a conversation on their own? These are learning objectives as well. Have the students have a sense of space? Can they have they understood shapes? Can they solve problems? There are many learning objectives which any teacher will always know whether the students can do or not. There are certain things where you have to specifically do an assessment. So my guess, really, or guess you can say my experience is that about 20-25% at the most of the curriculum needs to be formally assessed. The rest of the things, the teacher's normal teaching process is sufficient to know whether it is being learned or not. So I would simply keep a chart of my learning objectives, and the names of children. If a child can do it, same tick mark. If a child is half able to do it, I'll put a question mark or a cross. My objective is all the question marks and crosses should become tick marks. So it's a, again, it's not very complicated. It doesn't take much time. The way to do it is at the end of the day, spend 15 minutes on this. And really not do more than that. And if it needs more than 15 minutes, you're doing something wrong. You should not do it. So that way you know at all times you will know for it. So what do you do with that data? If you have a learning objective and you find lots of children have crosses and question marks, it means you have to repeat the whole thing again. That's all it means. Do it again the next day. If you find that most of the children are at the tick mark level, but a few, one or two or three or four or five, they don't have the tick mark, it means they need special attention. So you have to find a way to give them a special attention. So what does it do? This CCA helps you know whether you are succeeding in reaching out to children. It helps you take important decisions about what to do for the whole class and what to do for individual children. That is the purpose of CCA and nothing more than that. In Bihar, we ran a successful process to work on this. We did it in 60 schools and now it's expanded. And we were able to make a report card which is comprehensive, and it does not require a teacher to do much work. In one instance, we had a very interesting thing. The teacher asked the students to make a drawing of the human skeleton. Then she had 40 children or so. She gave 4 or 5 of them A, and the rest only got C or D or something. And she told them, this is why I gave them A, they have these qualities. Then the other children said, but if we improve our drawing, can we also get A? Alright. So they worked on it. So those who were in D, they came out to B. She said, you got so much here, but some one or two things are still missing. So when she said, okay, here one or two things are still missing, the children worked on it again until all the children got A. The point I'm making is that generally, evaluation assessment is seen as something which frightens you. But actually, it can be hugely motivating, done in a certain way. If it is transparent, if students know what I am supposed to do. And lastly, on this issue, I believe that children who are a little bit older, from say class 3 onwards, they can do self-assessment, they can fully participate in peer assessment with each other. And I really think that CCA is made an unnecessary bogey, and the reason is that you cannot do CCA or CCE until you do CCT. CCT is continuous and comprehensive teaching. Now, you don't teach through activities. You don't teach the entire range of learning objectives. Then you cannot do CCE. So that's the basic. So. I believe that, and this is a professional opinion, that whatever CBSE has done is hugely damaging to children and to teachers. It has simply increased the pressure without necessarily increasing learning. CCE is supposed to be a pedagogical tool. It's not a big evaluation event by itself. It's to be invisible almost. That's the objective behind CCE. It's part of the right to education. It's not a new additional imposition as it is being treated.